And so let's go back to Bomjon's manipulation with Buddhism. So he is hijacking the good name of Buddhism to make himself famous. He even allows people call him Buddha boy. He doesn't really protest against it. He could have protested much more strongly against being called Buddha boy, but it's just here and there he kind of mentions that he doesn't like that people call him Buddha boy, but he doesn't really mind it. So Bomjon is, he has always one truth for this group of people, another truth to another group of people, one truth for the Nepalese, one truth for the foreigners. And then the foreigners are telling the Nepalese, but Guruji told this and this, and the Nepalese say, no, because but Guruji told this and this. There is no one truth in Bomjon's cult. It's always according to the politics, how he wants to, whom he wants to recruit, whom he wants to fool, whom he wants to keep in illusion. Many people recognize this soon, that he's actually lying, because truth is only one. If you tell different truths to different people, and different truths for same people at different times, then what are you doing? You are lying. And the fact that he's lying had been recognized by the Buddhist lamas, many, many of them, the Kempos, even Rinpoche's, Gyansagan Rinpoche, who were confronting Bomjon after the Gaudimai, and Bomjon just dismissed them. Like, he accepted their support, their propagation. They also helped Bomjon to get lamas. So this is what he wanted. He needed young lamas, boys who are innocent, who doesn't understand too much. And it was romantic for them to live in the jungle and just be free, because in Bomjon's compounds there is no discipline like in a Buddhist monastery. They are just hanging around. This is what we... even Nika from Russia, she called it like it's a scout camp. It's like we had a pioneers in communist times, that we were like making fire and making singing together at the fireplace and having like a touristical experience somewhere in the forest. So Bomjon's compounds looked like that. No spiritual activity. And so Bomjon is, of course, Buddhist lamas, young lamas who had been living in strict disciplined monasteries before, and then suddenly they got to Bomjon's jungle compound with a lot of foreigner girls around with mini shorts and everything, and all these mobiles and the foreigners, the Chinese and the Thai and Vietnamese just give money to everyone, and Andrea Good as well, giving other people's money to everyone so that she gets loved by the Nepalese. Of course they like to stay, and they stayed there. Even if Gyansagar Guru himself and Prem Dorje Lama himself, they left Bomjon after the confrontation that he lied to them about coming to Gaudimai, and that he slept with girls while in front of the public he was playing the meditator. This is what they didn't like. So it's not that Buddhist lamas don't marry. The Nyingma, which is the lineage where most of Tamang lamas belong to, the Nyingma lineage of Buddhism from the main four Buddhist lineages, they can marry actually. But it's also a normal monogamic marriage. Not that they have permission, because they are lamas, they would have permission to sleep every week with another girl and not to marry them and send them to abortions like Bomjon is doing. No, they have a normal wife, they have children, and they continue their lama practice. My beloved old lama, Tamang Lama of Chalnakel, he was also like this. He was also married lama, but he was already old, so he was meditating. And he had a son, he had many children, But he was already living in his old age in the monastery. And so Bomjon's followers are spreading in Google that Bomjon is a Buddhist. And they are sneaking inside Buddhist forums and they are writing titles that Bomjon is the Buddha of our age, it's Buddha reincarnation, reincarnation of Buddha. They use these keywords everywhere because they want to brainwash people that Buddhism and Bomjon is the same. But no, already Bomjon had himself told that he has nothing to do with Buddha, he is higher than Buddha. In already back in 2012, Marty Donnelly told me when we met by accident in Lumbini that Guruji had a meeting with the foreigners and he told that he is higher attained than Buddha and that Buddha did not know his father, only his mother. I don't know what does this mean, but it was his exclamation. He told that Buddha is lower than himself. And he told them also, the smaller group of foreigners with a translator, he told them that Bomjon told them about himself that there was never ever any higher divine being on this earth than Bomjon himself. This was told to me by Marty Donnelly, who is an Australian, very, very fanatic follower of Bomjon. And still, how can you call yourself Buddhist? How can you call your guru Buddhist when that guru puts Gautama Buddha, the founder of Buddhism, the main core of Buddhism person, he puts under himself? So he cannot be a Buddhist if he disrespects Buddha. Because obviously for the Buddhists, there is no higher attainment than Gautama Buddha attained, which is nirvana. There are no upper and downer nirvana or this and that category of, there is one nirvana. There is no return from nirvana. That's why Bomjon cannot be even Buddha's reincarnation. What is the other fake claim of his followers, at his order of course, because Buddha is not reincarnating. The Rinpoches, who are reincarnating in the Tibetan Buddhist lineage, they also don't say that they are Gautama Buddha's reincarnations. They are saying that they are tulkus, or reincarnations, of certain highly attained bodhisattvas. So, in the Tibetan Buddhist concept, the bodhisattva is the one who is returning, who is just at the gate of nirvana, looks down and he decides to sacrifice his eternal bliss in nirvana and returns to the samsara to bring more people to nirvana.
Police and local officials are in Nepal, are becoming concerned over a teenage boy who's been locked in meditation, allegedly without food or water, in the jungle for 6 months. Thousands are flocking to see him, with some believing he is the Buddha reincarnated. Ram Bomjon was 15, sits cross-legged and motionless with eyes closed in a niche among the roots of a tree in the jungle of Barra.